Hi, myself Bharatwin. Our topic is banana leaf disease reduction. Our objective is to identify the banana leaf is diseased or not. For that, we are importing necessary libraries from the packages OpenCV and TensorFlow. And we are importing some of the important libraries like Keras, SQLite, Pandas, TensorFlow, Matplotlib. And for pre-processing, we are importing image data generator, load image, image to array. And we are importing some other machine learning libraries. Next, we are moving into data pre-processing. Here we are creating an image pre-processing function. In that, we are converting our colored image to grayscale. Then we are resizing the image and we are equalizing the contrast of an image for better analyzing. Then we are removing the noisy in the image using two blurries. Firstly, we are using Gaussian blur, then we are using median blur. Here I have used only the Gaussian blur for smoothing the image. Then we are segmenting the image for edge detection. I am here used the sawble edge detection. After creating this function, then I am calling this function for the images which I have for analyzing. The length of the whole data set is 120. That is, I have only 120 images. In that, 60 images were diseased and 60 images were healthy. The whole image data is shown in the array format. We are showing the 0, 0, 0, 0, number 6, 2. These and all the image pixels value in the images. Then we are showing the diseased image. Here I have plotted the diseased image. Then I have plotted the healthy leaf. After that, I am trying to shuffle the data randomly. The below shown are random label generator. As I have two types of image folder, the output is shown only in the binary. That is 1 or 0. Then I am implementing the classification. For that, I have imported the SVC, that is support vector classification, from the sklearn support vector machine, which is a supervised learning model for classification. Here I have two variables, one is feature and a target. In that, I have splitted the training and testing data set. For testing, I have splitted 20% of the data set. Then I have fitted the SVC model which I have imported here. Now I am fitting that model into our training sets. Then I have predicting the classification for the test data set. Then I am printing the accuracy score. Then I have printed the target variables. In my machine learning model, I have get an accuracy score of 87%. Now I am evaluating this using a classification report library from the sklearn matrix. The confusion matrix is a table used for describing the performance of the classification model. Here I have used for the test data sets and I am used the seaborn library for better description describing it will, and this plot will show the high rate of the diseased and disease, then healthy two points. Then I have moved into data augmentation. Data augmentation is a tool which will generate more data of an original image of original data. That is, it will duplicate the original image. Here I have duplicated the image for 60 images in the diseased class after 60 images in the healthy class. After that, I have extracted the data from the directories which I have. After that, I am plotting, I am converting that images into images. After that, I have shown the one image pixels in the array format. Here I have normalized, here I have used normalization because for the faster calculation, I have used that normalization. After that, I have plotted the one images. After that, I have splitted the training and testing data set. Then I have plotted, then I have shown here the data types of the training data set and testing data set. Now we will see how the data augmentation works for a single image. For single image, we are importing the library called expandDynge from NumPy. After that, we are loading the image, then converting image into NumPy for analyzing the model. After that, I have expanded the dimension to one sample. Then I have plotted the different types of the different duplication of the original images. This is the images of the duplicated. This is the. After that, I have created a model for better training understanding. Training. Here I have used a CNN, that is convolutional neural network. Here I have used four convolutional layers. After that, I have used a flattened layer. Then at last, I have fully connected a dense layer, that is output layer. Here, my output should be only 1 or 0. For that, it is totally 2. After that, I am compiling the model using optimizer Adam for the class function as pass categorical cross and repeat. Here, using a logic function calls, as we are normalized the layer in the last. Then I have used 25 approaches for training the 32 as a batch size for the training. Then we are evaluated the model for test data set. I have got the training accuracy 99.64% and the validation accuracy as 95.76%. After that, I have tested for the validation data set. After that, I have evaluated the model for test data set. On that, I have got 95.76% of accuracy. After that, I am predicting for testing data set. The results are shown below. Then I am summarizing the model which I have used. This is the model which I have used, summary of the model. After that, I have shown the accuracy. Then here I have plotted the loss and the accuracy comparisons. At last, I am predicting the my model should predict a new image. For that, I am taking a new image from the test data set. This model is predicting that 60 image in the test data set is a healthy leaf. We should cross verify this. So I have plotted this in the here. If you see this image, you can see that this image is a healthy leaf. After that, I have predicted the model, predicted for the test data set in one image, in the first image. That image is showing that this is a leaf, a diseased leaf. We also have to cross verify this. So, if you are plotting the first image, this is showing that that is a diseased leaf. Successfully, our model is built successfully. Thank you. My model predicted and detected the disease in the leaf. Thank you.